Kayak will have to be actually more comprehensive. We have a huge set of suppliers today, but we need to do more. We need to be more comprehensive to the customers. The second point is the mobile business. So the mobile is catching up on the web. We are having more and more traffic coming through that platforms, and we'll have to be more intuitive and give the right tools so the customers can perform bookings on the mobile sites. And the third and last point will be the customization of our site and anticipate the need of our users.
Well, some of the trends that I've identified in tourism have to do with the redefinition of wellness. So in the past, for example, we thought of wellness as going to a spa, and now we see new experiences that are coming up that have to do with riding retreats, with wine tastings, chocolate tastings, and things of that nature, all branded as wellness. We're also seeing much more mobile. We also see a lot more consumers that are asking for authentic experiences, and lots of brands providing experiences through the eyes of locals. So a lot of it is getting closer and more connected to the culture or the area that we're visiting.
Over recent years, we've seen incredible advances in technology, which has changed radically the way that we can purchase hotels. The internet, mobile products, you can even now book hotels through Google Glass. But one problem statement remains still unresolved, which was getting simple and easy and global access to the hotels, apartments, or any other types of accommodation you'd like to book, given the fragmented nature of the industry. So we believe in Amadeus, and it's our strategy to provide a single global sourcing platform, enabling all of those new technologies to connect to and allowing the buyers to find any hotel, any apartment, anywhere in the world under the right price and the right business model which suits them best. So we think that global sourcing problem will be one that's be tackled and driving the next 10 years of hotel innovation.
We have a direct impact on the environment, which we're very conscious of. But equally, the environment is an important part of how we run our business. So we try to integrate sustainability across different levels of our business, through the fleet, through how we carry out our operations, so by making them more efficient, introducing more fuel-efficient processes, training our crew and staff to think environmentally. And all of this adds to a saving for the business from a commercial point of view, which then is a benefit to the passenger, but equally reduces our impacts on the environment.
In the same way that experts go all over the place to find very good deals, they can do the same thing with user-generated content. They're going to go on TripAdvisor, for example, to get some advice on a trip and push it to the client, to his client. Second thing is that in the future, experts could be generating content as well, very highly qualified content that would be additional to the user-generated content that we have today. So we have two types of generated content, maybe mainstream generated content as we find on TripAdvisor, and maybe curated generated content with highly qualified experts who would do that for the client.